Real people, real talent, real voices. Right here in the DMV. We call it Hollywood in Washington, D.C. with your host, Tammy Barbosa.
My character is actually the mother of the main character when he was younger. And just as that main character is starting to head into some trouble, she sort of sees some things happening with him, but doesn't know how to proceed because the father was very strict and what will happen if this all comes out. And later on, we find out that he goes on a very unfortunate road before his redemption. So.
Well, in order for folks to know what happens, you'll have to see the movie. So congratulations again on your nomination here at the first In Demand Film Festival. So happy to have you here.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
Thank you so much. And I'm here with Cassandra Grant, otherwise known as
Lacey Lace.
Lacey Lace, indeed. And Cassandra, you are being nominated today. What are you being nominated for?
Best Supporting Actress for To Live and Die in D.C.
Wonderful. Yeah. There's a theme here, To Live and Die in D.C. Absolutely.
Okay.
And could you give us a sense of what your character is like?
My character was a lawyer. Because I was in a similar movie with June, and I was a district attorney. But To Live and Die in D.C., I was a lawyer.
Mm-hmm. Are you going to bill me for this time on the red carpet?
Not this time.
Thank you so much.
I object.
No. Okay.
Judge, I wish you the very best. And you hail from the DMV area?
Yes.
Wonderful. Is there anything else you'd like to tell our viewers?
I have three upcoming movie premieres that's coming up in October. I can't even think of the names of them. One is the Tides That Bind. The other one is Mercy Road. That's going to be hopefully aired on ABC. I have another one that's called, it's going to air in October, a movie premiere, Stripped from Insanity. And those are web series that's coming up all at one time. So I have a couple more red carpet events to celebrate for some of my work.
Well, good for you. What do you do in your spare time?
Talk to myself in the mirror.
Self-coaching.
No, yeah. I do work a full-time job also. HR specialist for the federal government. I also love family life, plants, veggies, and travel out with my friends, the two over there.
I know, I see.
They keep me busy. So I'm just loving life and just enjoying everything, enjoying life. Yeah.
Well, Cassandra Grant, otherwise known as Lacey Lace, congratulations on your nomination.
Thank you.
Best of luck to you.
Thank you.
Okay, and I have to my left here Kai Jones. And Kai, you have a nomination today, correct?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I too am nominated for Best Supporting Actress in the To Live and Die in D.C. in the role of the drug pusher.
Yeah, that's what I did.
That sounds rather intimidating, but you are such a kind lady. That's what acting is all about.
Right, you would never know that I push drugs. Acting, of course. And it was an experience. It was an experience. So, in acting, of course, you don't always play who you are. That's the joy of acting. You step into another role of somebody that's totally different than your lifestyle and how you live.
I love that. I always say you can be someone you're so not in real life and no one can hold you accountable because it's fiction.
Exactly.
Yes.
That's the best part about acting.
So what lies ahead for Kai Jones?
Well, quite a lot lies ahead for me. Thank you so much for asking. I continue to work on my craft. I take acting lessons. I'm involved in other, I guess you could say, movies. And I just finished a voiceover in a commercial in Richmond. And I have a series coming up. I'm doing another movie on Saturday. It's called One in a Million. I'm working on Mercy Road with Lacey. And I'm also working on a lot of other projects. So I'm really happy about it.
You know, the key to life is doing what you love, and you sound like you have a lot of chapters going on, a lot of puzzle pieces at the same time.
Right.
And we are wearing blue ribbons, and this is honor of human trafficking, correct?
Right. Exactly.
Yes. Recognition of human trafficking, folks. So during during the interviews, you will see many folks wearing blue ribbons, and it's all for the good, to bring awareness to the devastation of human trafficking and what each of us can do about it.
Yes, and it's very important to know that all of us have other lives, and Bella Levy has, this is her organization, and she's a crusader. And we're wearing these ribbons today because we want everybody to know that we're a family, and we are here for her, and we want to stamp out this scourge that's destroying people's lives.
Well put. Thank you so much, Kai, and I look forward to interviewing Bella in just a moment. So thank you. The best of luck today on your nomination.
Oh, thank you so much, and it was a pleasure speaking with you.
Well, thank you. Okay. You as well.
Thank you.
And folks, I'm here with John Thompson. John is no stranger to the camera, and the suit jackets are always, you never disappoint with the suit.
That's right, Nancy.
Congratulations, and what is your nomination today?
My nomination is Best Supporting Actor in the Feature Film. The name of the film is To Live or Die in Washington, D.C. And
Do you live or die?
Oh, I live. Okay. I definitely live.
We are glad that you live in this movie, but don't tell the viewers the rest of
oh, not at all.
How it goes.
Not at all.
So can you describe your actor in To Live and Die in D.C.?
My actor character name actually is Donald. And let's say I'm on the crime side, but, you know, have a little flair with the judge, you might say. So it's very interesting. So if you haven't seen the movie, you should.
Sounds quite mysterious. And do you have that nice smile as you are in your particular role? Something tells me no, because it sounds like you're a bad guy.
You never know. You never know.
Okay.
Just have to see the movie and find out. To Live and Die, Washington, D.C. Check it out.
All right. Well, definitely. That's a teaser if I've ever heard one. Mm-hmm. What lies ahead, John?
What lies ahead, I've just been casted to be in Deadly Winning Numbers, so I plan on doing my thing in that film as well. And shout out to the director for that, Lance. And
Lance's last name?
Lance's last name. You know, that's funny. In this game, we go by the first name.
We'll have Lance here to tell
it.
Himself.
Of course.
Yeah, I don't think it's Armstrong.
No, I don't think it's Armstrong. Not Armstrong.
Could it be Hill?
It's Hill.
It's Lance Hill. You are correct. See, so you must sing the movie then, right?
I just know Lance. Okay. I was testing you, John.
I know. That's
okay. You pass. You pass with flying colors.
Thank you.
Yes. Well, What Lies Ahead is that movie, and anything else?
That movie, also lies ahead. Of course, my first love is comedy, right? So I was doing comedy before I got into acting. I don't know if you all been watching Saturday Night Live, you know the individual, Kenan Thompson?
Yes.
He just so happened to have the same last name, but he just so happened to email me to let me know that I've been selected to be in his comedy series this season, his 13th year, so yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Lucky 13, right?
Lucky 13.
13th year. Oh,
they say that's a lucky number.
Yes.
So I'm gonna take full advantage.
Oh, well, let us know how it goes. Maybe the next time you're on the red carpet, we'll know about that.
Yes, you will.
Yes. Oh, John, best of luck to you today.
Thank you.
Hello, and I'm with Mr. Dennis Walters. Dennis, again, no stranger to these types of festivals, even though this is the first annual Indie Man Film Festival. I want to say Indie Film, so Indie Man Film Festival.
Man.
You have a nomination today, correct?
Yes, for Best Original Soundtrack for Return of Jade Brooks by June.
Yes.
So,
and you just shared with me that very soundtrack is going to be used in another movie, correct?
Right, in Saving Anna.
Yes.
Which highlights human trafficking, correlating with the ribbons we're wearing today.
Absolutely.
Seems to be the theme, so excited about that, to be able to bring awareness to this plight.
So I follow Dennis on Facebook, and your song is just blowing up the scene. And what is the song title?
Missing Children.
Yes.
Missing Children. It's actually done some things that I would not expect. It's won over 30 international film festivals in the last, 50 days, and it's still going. It's released worldwide. On every platform, Amazon, Spotify, you name it. And it's being played in Europe a lot, in Italy, in Africa, South Africa, in the UK. And I keep getting emails from station managers wanting to play it just got one a little while ago, so it's really exciting. I'm excited for it.
Good for you. And share with our viewers again, Dennis, how folks can listen to it.
Oh, you can listen to it. You can listen to it or buy it on Pandora, Spotify, Amazon, iTunes, Apple, Deezer, whatever your choice is. It's on every single platform out there.
Titled YouTube. Missing Children.
Missing Children.
Right. Yes. Well, best of luck today on your music nomination. It's always good to see you. And you are color coordinating with the ribbon nicely. Was this planned?
No.
No.
But this is pretty cool.
Yeah,
I just noticed
it's very cool. Well,
it's working out. Yeah,
it is, yes. Bringing more awareness, right, to why we're wearing.
Oh, yes. And Bella, this is her organization, and she also is going to be using Missing Children to promote her organization. So it's kind of a big correlation, Bella and June and the films, and it's really exciting.
Well, thank you for helping bring awareness to human trafficking through your music.
Oh, absolutely. Thank you.
Appreciate Always good it. To see you, Dennis.
You too. Thank you.
Patrick Alberta Sims, a name not to be forgotten at all. So good to see you again.
It's always good to see you, too. It's good to be here.
Thank you. Now, I understand you are presenting today. So
I
you're
am.
Presenting an award, and you were in a film, you were in a shoot this mm-hmm. morning.
Yes.
Before the In Demand Film Festival even
yes.
began.
Yes.
Are you able to give our viewers a teaser about that?
Just a little bit. I'm actually playing the first lady, the pastor's wife, in the movie Saving Anna. So we had some scenes today, and we'll have some other scenes tomorrow. And I really love what's happening here because I had a dream years ago about children that were being human trafficked. And I love an organization in Oklahoma called the Red Cord, and they are real big on human trafficking as well, an organization against it, human trafficking as well. So it's, I like that.
And so you traveled here from Oklahoma to be with us, correct?
Yes, I love you guys because this is my third time on my penny. So,
well, you
yes.
must love us then, right?
I do.
Absolutely.
I do love
well,
you.
Thank you. Yes. So, third time's a charm, right?
Yes, absolutely.
Yes. Patrick, would you like to mention the foundation in memory of your daughter?
Yes, it's called the ksimsfoundation.org. And that's another beautiful story right now because I think everybody, so many people now are seeing it in the news about Camp Lejeune, North Carolina. 900,000 to 1 million families were affected by the poison water. My daughter and my husband were both, that was major factors in their death. And also I have a beautiful daughter, 42-year-old daughter, that's at my home now who also is suffering from a plethora of illnesses that's also connected to that poison water. But we're getting the word out, and the book that I wrote mentions that. But what one of the things that I'm really excited about is that Voice Media in Hollywood is collaborating with me right now on an audio podcast about the mystery of my family and our journey with this toxic water.
Well, Patrick, your story, I'm so sorry that you and your family have had to live through this. And the book that you mentioned, what is the name of this book?
It's Eyewitnessed, Believe What You Cannot See. And it's regarding a lot of miracles because we didn't know, you know, what was happening to our family. We were eating good. We exercised and all of these things that doctors couldn't identify, but we found out in 2009, and I started intensive research. And now, what I've known all along, the world is finding out that that's what was happening to us.
Thank you for your hard work for the last 13 years. That is a long time, and it's always so good. It's always so gratifying to see you. You always have a smile on your face, regardless of what's going on in your life, and you are admired greatly.
Thank you so much. It's great to be
everyone,
here.
Everyone, as we continue to have these wonderful interviews on the red carpet for the first annual In Demand Film Festival, I'm here with Terry Briscoe. Terry, you are being nominated today. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Yes, could you share with us what the nomination is and for what?
I am being nominated for Best Supporting Actor for Return of Jake Brooks.
All right, so tell us a little bit about your character.
I am one of the henchmen of the boss, and I'm just basically just there to do whatever he tells me to do, and to he tells me to go and get him, I go and get him.
Kind of a scary dude, huh?
Look at his face. Is this a scary face?
I meant your boss, not you.
Oh yeah, big boss is a big scary dude. Yeah, he's a big scary guy.
Again, as we've said in earlier interviews, you can be someone you're so not. So a henchman, I don't think you are.
No, definitely not a henchman. That's the best thing about acting. You do get to be someone that you're not.
Correct.
It's fun.
And it's okay.
It is okay. It's fun.
It is. So, Terry, what's in the next chapter for you?
Well, I am a voice actor by trade, as you know. So I do the intro to it.
Can't you tell?
So I am currently in an audio drama called The Dad Bod of Destiny, which you can find on all of your fine podcasting platforms. And I will be actually in a video game that's going to be coming out at the end of this month. And that game is called Breaker's World.
And
I did Lance's movie also recently. I did my scenes for that, and now Deadly Winning Numbers, and that'll be coming out soon.
And do you hail from the DMV area?
Can't you tell? Of course I do. I'm from Northeast.
Well, Terry, always great to see you. I know you're no stranger to WMIFF, the World Music and Independent Film Festival, and we did a little collaboration not too long ago.
A little bit.
Yes, just a little bit. We did a lot virtually.
Yes.
So, great to see you again.
Great to see you too. Thank you.
Action. It's all in the family, isn't it? These two fine gentlemen to my left here. So we have Damian Lynch, who is the grandson of Bruce Allen Dawson. Thank you so much for coming to the first annual In Demand, right, Film Festival. And Bruce, I understand that you are being nominated today.
Yes, I am.
Okay, could you share with our viewers for what?
I'm being nominated for Best Actor in To Live and Die in Washington, D.C., and Best Supporting Actor in The Return of Jake Brooks.
And Damian, you, congratulations to you.
Thank you.
And Damian, you are an actor as well?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, could you share with our viewers what you've been in?
Well, I think To Live and Die in D.C. was my first film. And then after that, it's really been stale after that. But yeah, just To Live and Die in D.C.
Something about your life tells me that it's not stale. So we're just going to cut that from the, right? We'll just rewind and not say that, right? So do you learn a lot from your grandfather?
Yes, he teaches me everything I know about acting, and there's definitely some more to come.
Right. And what do you aspire to do?
I aspire to, one, acting, and I like to play a lot of video games, so, you know, maybe be like, you know, a game developer or something like that. But for right now, definitely acting.
Bruce, I know you're just chomping at the bit to say something.
Well, he actually played the young protagonist in To Live and Die in Washington, D.C. as his first role, and he did a rather good job.
Protagonist. Okay. What did you think about your character?
It kind of fit my life in a way. You know what I'm saying? With, like, the family and stuff and all that. But it was really fun doing it. It was really fun doing it, and I really enjoyed it, and I wish I could go back and just relive it.
It's kind of like eating Doritos. You just can't have one, right? You have to go back and back and back and work on your craft, and you have someone who's very close to you who is an awesome actor. So there you go. Yes. All right, Bruce, what do you think about your nominations?
I'm flattered. I've never been nominated for anything before, so this is a first, and I'm really excited about it. It's quite an honor.
Well, congratulations on not one, but two nominations today. And Damian, it's great to see you again. Yes, I know you were at WMIFF.
Yes, I was.
And it's great to see you. And best of luck in your acting pursuits and your gaming pursuits.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
I really appreciate that.
Thanks for coming. Hello, everyone. I'm here with Alan Greenstein. And Alan, this is your first time at a festival coordinated by Master Jun de Guizhou, correct?
That's correct.
Yes. So, of course, I'm going to ask you, what brings you here today?
Well, I was Bella Levy of the Bella Levy Foundation. By the way, I'm on the board of directors of that. She mentioned this festival and decided to come.
Well, wonderful. So you just showed me your business card. I'm going to quiz you on that. What is the name of your business and what is that about?
Okay. It's called Support Our Hashtag Creatives. And the goal of this organization is to, typically underrepresented demographics have as much chance as everybody else to get their particular projects seen and distributed. As I said,
Well, thank you. That sounds like wonderful work, very gratifying work, and you're making a difference for the underserved community members.
Yes.
Well, welcome to the first annual In Demand Film Festival, and we hope to see you at the World Music and Independent Film Festival next year. We've already had it this year, but welcome to the family.
Thank you.
I'm here with Crystal Stearns. Crystal, I love it when folks act for the first time because I really want to hear, and I'm sure our viewers want to know, what your experience was like. So tell us, please, the name of the movie and what your role was and how you feel about it.
Well, the name of the movie is Saving Anna, and I was a church parishioner, and I really enjoyed it because it was the first time I've ever done this before, and it actually came very easily to me. So, it was a church scene, and there was like two different scenes in it that I got to be in, and that was, I just really enjoyed it. I had fun. So,
did you catch the acting bug?
Yes, I did. I did.
Because it does
I love
go viral. It really does
I
go viral.
I love it. I love it.
So may we say this is the first of many.
This is the first of many.
Wonderful. You shared with me, Crystal, your foundation, and I would love for our viewers to know about it.
Yes. I am the founder and CEO of Voice for Victims. I'm from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, and I have a podcast, Voice for Victims, that I interview victims, survivors, advocates, doctors, therapists, anyone that wants to spread awareness in the community about victimization. I don't narrow it down to a specific thing. Anyone can be a victim, and I welcome anyone on the show. I feel that everyone deserves to have a voice. A lot of people suffer in silence, and that's why I created this. I'm actually a survivor of sexual harassment and abuse. And I actually, that's the reason why I started it, because I'm trying to spread awareness, and I want people to realize you can take control of your life, because I was able to take control back of my life. If you Google my name, Crystal Stearns, you'll find out my story. And there's actually a show out there on me about who I am. So, and then you can find the Voice for Victims. It's voiceforvictimspodcast.com. That's my website, and I also have crystalstearns.com. So, thank you.
Well, thank you. You were anticipating my questions because I was going to ask you how folks would be able to hear you, find you. Yes.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Well, thank you so much, and welcome to the DMV acting family. It's so great to have you.
Yes. Thank you.
And safe travels back.
Thank you. Nice meeting you.
Nice to meet you as
thank
well.
You so much.
It's no wonder why your first name is Bella. I am here with such a beauty, Bella Levy. You have more than one title, so I was able to memorize the shorter of the two, and that is Miss Maryland Elite, currently. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And you are also?
A few weeks ago, I traveled to South Carolina, and I was crowned today's International Woman.
Wow. Double congratulations. Yes, it's
thank
okay
you.
To clap. We can clap. Absolutely. We do have a live audience,
yes,
here, don't we?
So nervous.
It's okay. No worries. Now, I understand this was your platform and still is.
Yes, ma'am. So I am the creator of the Blue Ribbon Project, which focuses on awareness, prevention, and education methods against human trafficking. The official color of human trafficking is royal blue, and the official awareness month is January. And in observance of the month, I am having a big gala, which we will promote later and find out how everybody can get involved.
Well, thank you, Bella, for all of that information. How may folks learn more about you and your platform?
Thank you. You can find me on all social media platforms. On Facebook, it's Bella Levy. And on Instagram, it's BellaChka2021. And my website is bellalevy.org. I have something very unique to my foundation is I have a QR code, and whoever scans the QR code goes straight to my website. And the very first thing it asks you is, do you need police? And if you press yes, the police are automatically called. And because each phone has a tracking device, then you're able to find, the police are able to find where that call is coming from.
Thank you. You know, there are some people in life who are reactive and there are some people who are proactive, and you are definitely the latter. You are a proactive individual.
Thank you.
And all in the name of trying to stamp out human trafficking.
Yes.
And folks, she has a full-time job unrelated to everything we just mentioned, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
You are another hero.
They called us during COVID. They called us Super Shiro and Scrubs. I work nights at the hospital doing radiology.
Thank you so much. Full
Thank
time.
You. Thank you. Yeah, full time.
Yes. Well, I don't know where to begin, so I'm just going to sum it all up and tie it in a pretty blue ribbon. Thank you for your amazing work.
Thank you.
From beginning to end. Hello, everyone. I am here with Shefani Gaius. Now, Shefani, not only do you help out tremendously at festivals like the In Demand Festival that we're having today and the World Music and Independent Film Festival, you're also an actress and you're being nominated today.
Yes, I am. Tammy, it's so wonderful to be here with you, and I'm so excited. I feel incredibly honored and truly blessed to be a part of this family. It truly is a family. We have Master June has created a community of creatives. And to be among that and a part of it and to be nominated today is really incredible.
Could not have said it better. Nicely put, Shefani. What is your nomination today?
Best Actress for The Lion of Judah Legacy.
I was hoping someone would mention that movie.
Yes.
So Francisco Anderson, right? Director,
yes.
Writer.
Yes. Director, writer, producer, lead actor extraordinaire. This is a brainchild and a vision baby, a dream baby of his, a passion project to tell his story in light of veterans finding ways to heal, finding their magic and reclaiming who they are, remembering who they are. And it's an incredible film. We just had the premiere, was it in July, in celebration of Francisco's 50th birthday. Little plug, I hit 40. Oh, we're not supposed to say that, right? However, we're a couple of days apart, so I feel like that was, although I missed it, that was one of my birthday gifts as well, was to have that premiere of the first feature film I've ever been a part of as a lead.
Congratulations. Yes, that's wonderful. And there are many Lion of Judah movies out there, but this is Lion of Judah Legacy. Indeed. So that's how you can find it out there, including on IMDb to learn about it. What lies ahead for Shefani?
Wow, so many wonderful things. What lies ahead for me at the moment, I'm a quantum flow practitioner in training. And so working with creatives, as you know, we are actors, we take on stories and traumas and dramas to tell real life visions and stories of others who have been in pain. In education and to enlighten others, and we use our art, our craft, to do so. So as a quantum flow practitioner, my goal and hope is to work with creatives in realigning their nervous system. Kind of like right now, I'm nervous, so I'm sparkling.
Listening.
I don't sweat, I glisten and I sparkle. However, because I'm not breathing properly, and I know this, we all know this, my body temperature is rising. So when we go to auditions and we find ourselves in stressful situations, there are certain breath techniques and ways in which we can realign that nervous system and truly tap a little bit deeper and perhaps sink a little bit deeper into our characters.
Okay, Shefani, I'm calling you before my next one.
Yes, please.
Deal.
Yes, ma'am. Let's do it.
It's always so good to spend time with you and good to see you. And best of luck to you.
Thank you so much. I would love to ask, what's next for you?
To be continued. It's not about the, it's not about, it's about you.
Part of the family.
Hi folks, I am here with Adif Dajani, and you, my dear, are being nominated today. Is that correct?
That is correct. I am being nominated for Best Actor DMV for Lion of Judah Legacy.
So, what is your role?
I get to play Lou Tigerpaw, the Nemesis. I had a blast being evil.
He says with a smile, I'm not quite sure I'm understanding this.
Well, in this case, this was a challenge for me. I'm used to doing different accents in theater, but in this case, I had to do a Jamaican accent with a slight Scottish accent. So it took a lot of work for me to get into this role, but when I got into it, I had a lot of fun.
Oh, good for you, Adif. That's wonderful. So it was a very challenging role
yes.
in the accent department.
It's challenging the accent. Also, I had to sing and engage in combat choreography, where the director was directing me in Hyushu-jitsu online because we were still Zooming. And so getting into combat choreography while doing it over Zoom was definitely okay. a challenge.
I'm tired just listening. Well, do you have any future acting gigs?
Yes, actually I do. On the theater side, I'm an adjudicator for WATCH, the Washington Area Theater Community Honors. So I do local theater and I adjudicate theater as well. And then thanks to the connections through my fellow singer, Frank Anderson, and amazing sensei, June, yes. that I am, we are in production right now for Saving Anna, and a future gig is Love Controls Everything. And the thing which I really like about all three movies, Lion and Judah Legacy, Saving Anna, and Love Controls Everything, is that there is one common thread, love.
What more is there to say after that? Congratulations, Adif. Best of luck today on the nomination, and I look forward to working with you on Love Controls Everything.
I look forward to it as well.
Thank you. I'm here with Savannah Champ. Savannah, welcome to the DMV acting family. This is wonderful. It's so good to have you here. And I understand this is your debut presence as far as a festival by Master June de Guisa. So this is your first. Yes, welcome.
Yes, thank you. I had a pleasure of being a part of Saving Anna. And also, he also added me to a few other movies, Dangerous Cattle Game and Love Controls Everything.
Well, wonderful. So Saving Anna, what is your role in that movie?
Well, I just come in on church roles, mm-hmm. Greeting the pastor and just on the roles.
And Love Controls Everything, what is your character in that?
I'm not for sure yet, but he's supposed to send me my script soon.
Okay, it's not even hot off the press. It's still on the press.
Yes.
Okay, that's wonderful. Well, what lies ahead for you, Savannah?
Everything.
Oh, I love that answer.
Everything lies ahead of me. So I'm just waiting to see what God brings. What kind of doors he opened up for me.
Well, it sounds like he's opening up many doors for you.
Yes.
And do you live in the D.C., Maryland?
Yes,
Virginia.
Right now I reside in Silver Spring, Maryland, but I'm from originally D.C.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. Well, so good to have you here, and I look forward to seeing you at future festivals and on future movie sets.
Thank you.
Thank you. And I'm with this lovely young lady named Irma Anderson, and Irma, it's always good to see you at festivals.
Thank you so much. I'm so happy to be here. I've waited all my life to be in a movie.
And it happened.
Yes,
in which
it
movie
is.
Are you in?
I'm in The Lion of Judah Legacy, Frank Anderson, director, producer, and star.
Okay, Anderson. Any relation?
My son. My wonderful son.
I am clapping, yes. Proud mom, absolutely. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
What was your role in Lion of Judah Legacy?
Well, Mama Titi, of course.
Okay.
And it was wonderful. Yes, absolutely wonderful. The wonderful people I've met. Wanted to be in the movie all my life. Celebrated my 80th yesterday. I finally made it.
That's wonderful.
So I'm thrilled.
So was your son easy on you during
no.
the movie?
No.
No?
No, he was not. You know, whispering, when you get closer, straighten up, Mom. Straighten up. So it was a wonderful experience, and all the wonderful people I have met during this time, and I hope to continue to see them in the future.
Well, we are proud of you, and we are proud of your son, Frank Anderson.
Yes.
Absolutely. And Irma, it's always good to see you. Congratulations on getting beyond this birthday, number one, right?
Yes.
And number two, finally being in your first movie.
Yes. Thank you so much. Thank you, people.
Okay. Thank you. Bless you. This man absolutely needs no introduction in the house here, but maybe for our viewers. Frank Cisco Anderson, knower of all Lion of Judah Legacy. Congratulations on a fantastic movie.
Oh, thank you, Tammy, and thanks to everyone and stuff in the MJD family. I love you guys. Thanks.
So you have many, many roles in this movie. I don't have enough fingers.
Oh, it's true. Yeah, I'm the executive producer, also the writer and the lead actor, and the co-producer, blah, blah, blah.
Director?
No, June's a director.
Right, that would be nice to June DeGuisa.
Exactly, yeah. And she did a great job, at too, as always, so thanks.
So, do you have a sense of when folks will be able to view it?
Yes, right now it's in post-production. It should be finished by next month, Halloween at the latest, and then I'll get it out to the film festival circuit, and then maybe next spring or summer, should be going to Tubi, Amazon, so I keep everyone posted, and I'm really excited about that. So.
Yes, yes. Yeah. We are so proud of you. This is your first movie for producing, writing, etc.
Julia, and soundtrack as well.
So. Yes, yes.
The music.
Yes, and something about a Grammy or two nominations, maybe?
Oh, yeah. Well, I'm submitting it to all the Grammy, Cannes Film Festival, Tribeca, yes. Everything. So this movie will definitely be a wonderful platform for all of us to take it to the next level. You know, just keep living the dream.
Well, I know your mom is super sweet. I just interviewed your mom, Irma Anderson, and the apple does not fall far from the tree at all. So, no. It's always so great to see you, Frank, and to work with you. And thank you for the opportunity to be in The Lion of Judah Legacy. I had a blast. It was amazing.
Thank you so much, Sam. You killed it as well. Thanks to everyone. Love you guys.
And love you too. Love you too.
Thanks. Sure.
It is the Karen, Will, and Gwen show. Yes, it is. Yes. So let me begin with Karen. Hi.
Kara.
It is the Kara, Will, and Gwen show. Kara, it's so nice to have you here. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Yes. So what would you like to say to our viewers?
I'm just excited to be here. It's my first red carpet in a while, so good to be with everybody.
And you wore red for the red carpet. How appropriate is this?
Very appropriate.
Well, it's good to have you here as well.
Thank you for being here.
Will,
right.
Hi. It's good to see you again.
It's good to see you all.
Thank you. What brings you here?
I am here to possibly get an award.
Okay, so you were being nominated.
No, I don't even know. I don't think I would.
Are you not being nominated?
He's a special guest.
I'm a special guest.
You are a special guest. Yeah. Yes, Will. Okay.
And but I still might take one of those.
And you are an actor. You are
yes,
an actor.
I'm
yes. And what was your last film that you acted in?
Lion of Judah and The Legacy. And I was Cheeto.
Cheddar.
Because everything's better with Cheddar. Let me get that
you were in my head just now.
Yeah,
you stole
right.
my line. Seriously.
<You're
right. laughs> Thanks, Will.
It was a nice role to play. I was Gwen's brother, as usual. and she was having problems with a guy, Cisco.
As usual.
And I was stuck in the middle.
As usual.
And I had a good
time. It wasn't much of a stretch.
I enjoyed myself a lot.
Well, good. I'm so glad. It's always good to see you, Will. Gwen, I'm going to pass this mic to you because my arm is not long enough. So always great to see you. And tell me, what have you been up to lately?
I've been doing exactly what he's saying.
I'm
here.
Will, could you help
all the film and everything that I've been doing with Wes to work with June and Frank and Cesar, like, for years. I've been doing this for years. It's not new. Mm-hmm. It is not new to me. This is like what? So,
Deja Vu, Live and Die in D.C.
Yes. Embrace of Mateo's Blood.
Maybe one or two of them.
Yes.
And
yes.
What was it? Kill Jay Brooks.
Yes.
All up in it.
And Lion of Judah. And the next one coming up will be, what is it?
Rescue Anna.
Saving Anna. Either way, we're going to do it.
All day long, we're going to do it. It should be fun.
May I say, whatever role Gwen puts her mind to, she nails it. 100. Absolutely nails
thank
it.
Thank you very much.
And that is an understatement, truly.
Thank
so
you.
So you are a very talented actress, and it's always good. Are you being nominated today, Gwen?
I'm absolutely nominated
okay,
today.
What is your nomination today?
Best Supporting Actress.
Mm-hmm.
With a bunch of great actresses, though, it doesn't matter. Anybody who wins, it wins. Like, because this room, don't make me cry, this room is filled with talent.
Amen.
Every single one of them.
That is so true. And shy of, okay, so you don't cry anymore.
I won't cry a little bit.
You don't want your makeup to run.
No, it's already running. So, don't matter.
So, Kara, Will, Gwen, thank you so much for being on the red carpet today, and we'll see you at the festival in just a moment.
Yes, we will.
Thank you.
Amen.
I'm here with Nico Booth. Nico, welcome to the festival. It's so good to see you.
Thank you for having me, yes.
You're very welcome. Now, I understand that you have acted or are going to act in two films, is that correct?
Yes, that's correct. I'm going to be Correction Officer Dale in Saving Anna, and then in Lance Hill's upcoming movie, I'm going to be the Detective Bruce.
Correctional officer, detective, sensing a lot of law enforcement here.
It's funny how that worked out. Yeah, I guess I had the look.
Are you in law enforcement in real life? That you could admit.
I spent a few years in the Marines, and then after that did some other things. So I've got a little bit of a authority background.
Well, thank you for your service.
Thank
Once
you.
A Marine, always a Marine. So, yes, thank yes. you for your service on that. And what lies ahead for Nico?
For the last couple years, I've been producing concerts in the local Filipino community. I've had the pleasure to work with Geneva Cruz, Bamboo, Arnel Pineda, the lead singer of Journey, quite a few other bands. So I keep myself active in the entertainment realm.
Well, that's wonderful. I don't think that we will be hearing the last of you anytime soon. So congratulations, Nico Booth. Two movies coming up, and we will absolutely look for you.
Yes, I look forward to it as well.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. So this is a really easy name to remember, and I've seen you many, many times, Lance Hill. Lance Hill, ladies and gentlemen. Lance, first of all, thank you for helping to coordinate the In Demand first film festival. This
yes.
is wonderful.
Yes,
it's
sorry.
Always good to see you.
Yes, you
and
too,
what
too.
Would you like the viewers to know? There's so much to know about Lance.
Well, I'm nominated here for Best Actor in DMV for my movie, To Live and Die in D.C. Excited about that. Just excited about just being here among these great actors and producers and directors and everything. I'm pretty much got the writing bug right now because I'm doing a lot of writing, like different. I wrote probably by four. I wrote four movies so far, but I haven't put them out. I'm just writing, so I got the writing bug now. So, but I'm actually working on a new film called Deadly Winning Numbers.
Daily Winning Numbers.
Deadly.
Oh, deadly.
Deadly Winning Numbers.
I'm thinking lotto, right? Daily Winning Numbers.
It has to do something with lottery. Yes, it does. Don't want to spill too much about the movie, but all I can say is, you know, if you ever hit the lottery, don't trust your friends or people you think are friends.
Okay.
That's all. That, I'm leaving it like that till the movie come out.
Dun, dun, dun. Dot, okay. dot, dot.
That's
yes.
all I'm saying.
To be continued.
So I'm going to leave it like that. I don't want to spill out on it. But other than that, just working on different projects, you know, working with June, kind of put some ideas together on some things that we can kind of just push forward throughout the years. And hopefully this event here was our first event. This would be a great event, and then we could kind of step it up next year and just keep stepping it up and make it big every year. I mean, that's our goal for this.
I have no doubt. You
yeah.
know, you've got to start somewhere, and
gotta
this being
yes.
the inaugural first annual,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes. But other than that, I mean, I'm just like I said, I'm just doing my thing and just staying in the movie, keeping the movie things going, and acting, and just doing different stuff, just staying relevant, you know. And so that's.
And your writing, this is wonderful that
yes,
you have the writing
yes.
bug now.
Yeah, I got the writing bug. I mean, I got a bunch of books where I just write movies and come up with ideas. And it could be 3 a.m, I would get up and like, oh man, I would just jot it down.
Sleep is definitely overrated in the
yeah,
Lance
yeah,
Hill.
It
life.
Is, I mean,
yes.
it is. But I mean, I come up with these ideas and I write stuff down and it makes sense. And that's my wife is my, she goes, she looks after all my, everything I write, she goes over it she gets it. She gets like, oh wow, this is good. This is good. So I know it's good.
Behind every, okay, so
I know it's good.
Behind every successful man is
a great woman.
You got it. Congratulations,
thank you,
Lance.
Appreciate it.
Always great to see you,
too,
and can't wait to hear what's going to go on the next time you have a microphone in front of you.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. All right.
So I'm here with Tone Butta and Hannah George. So, Tone, I'll start with you.
Yes, ma'am.
First of all, it's great to see you again.
Always a pleasure.
Thank you. I understand, are you performing today? Is that
correct? Yes, I am. Definitely I want to bless the mic. Shortly, me and Hannah George, Real Business Ministries. Hannah George is a Christian singer, and I'm a soul hip-hop artist. We both are part of Real Business Ministries. So we're going to be performing. We got some new unreleased tracks today we're going to be performing. But I'm also in the movie Saving Anna. I'm a special guest also, as well as I play the pastor's assistant, Pastor Brown's assistant.
So, assistant pastor, is it a role that you, how may I say this, are you a good assistant pastor? Or do you defy people? Or are you not allowed to say?
Let's just say I'm good for now. I'll put it like this. I'm a servant of God. So even behind the camera, when the cameras are off, I'm a man of the Lord. So playing that role isn't even like a role to me. You know, I'm anything that God called me to be. Whatever he want to use me as, that's what I am.
Thank you so much, Tone.
Most definitely.
I look forward to seeing you in more than one movie.
Most definitely.
And congratulations being here today, and I look forward to hearing you perform.
Thank you.
So you are performing with Hannah George. Hannah, thank you for being here. Welcome. And tell us about what we're about to hear with you and Tone.
Firstly, I want to say it's a pleasure being here to perform under Real Business Ministry with the very popular hip-hop artist Tone Butta. But it's my first time, well, my second time actually performing for an award show under Real Business, so I'm just happy to be here again. I'll be singing. I was also involved in the film Saving Anna, just in the congregation looking at the assistant pastor. But yeah, that's all for now. Yes, I'm excited. Thank you.
Well, we're about to hear you, right, in the coming minutes. So we're excited to have you both here. And many, many more years in your musical pursuits. Absolutely, yes.
Lord willing.
Yes, indeed. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Love the dress, too.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. I didn't pay him to say that. And I'm here with Genevieve Ifanchuhu, and I understand that you will be performing, Genevieve.
Yes. Yeah, I'll be performing one of my songs called Majesty. I'm a gospel artist, and I'm also an actress.
So tell me, what will we see you in, or what can we see you in movie-wise, as far as acting?
We just concluded a movie, and we premiered the movie on August the 12th. So the movie is called Shadows of America, and I starred in the movie.
Wonderful. Leading lady. Yes?
Yes.
And what was your character like?
So the movie is talking about abuse against women, and it's more especially African immigrants in the United States of America. So I played the abused woman that came from Africa. Yeah. My director is an advocate that uses movie to tell people to stop the wrong thing, to advocate for women, and to create an awareness so that it can stop. It was so touching. After playing the movie and I watched the movie, at first I burst into tears. Though I was the one in the movie, because it looks so real, like a life story.
Which also speaks to your amazing ability to act, because it felt real.
Yes. Because you have to adapt the character that you're playing, regardless of what it is like. try to make people to understand, because we are telling story. I heard somebody saying we educate people through movie, and we want them to really understand by acting. It's not all about verbal, like some actions.
Yes.
Some actions will tell people this is what is going on, and a lot of people, they are ignorant of what is happening, and some people are already in it, but they don't know what it is, or they don't know what to do. But through the movie, we were able to tell people to reach out, ask for help. Don't let it to be too late. Don't get yourself killed. So it was a very nice movie.
Well, it sounds like you are a master of character development, truly.
Yeah, the point is that I also am a writer, and I was involved in writing the movie.
Mm.
Yes.
So you felt even more compelled.
Yes.
Right. Congratulations, Genevieve. And
thank you.
I look forward to, we all look forward to hearing you and seeing you perform today.
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you. I'll be performing Majesty until then. We'll hear the song.
Mm.
Yes.
Thank you. It's great to meet you.
Thank you so much.